Hello, and welcome to another Tank Encyclopedia Voiced article. I'm your host, Wood, and today I'll be covering the second part of a video series on the North Korean 323 armored personnel carrier. This time, we will cover the APC's service life and variants. More discreet than North Korean main battle tanks, it is a very important workhorse of North Korea's military, used for a wide variety of roles. If you like our videos and want to support us, please consider donating on Patreon or PayPal. All of the funds will be used to improve future Tank Encyclopedia content. Any help will be greatly appreciated. Before we move on with the APC of choice for North Korea, we'd like to give a shout out to fellow YouTube channel Battle Order. While we focus on individual vehicle types, they focus on how these vehicles fit into military units, country doctrines, and general nitty-gritty stuff related to ground warfare, armored or not. An excellent example is their recent amazing video on the future of Japanese tank forces. Check them out and leave a comment saying Tank Encyclopedia sent you. By modern standards, the 323 may not seem to be a very impressive vehicle. However, in the context of the early 1970s, it stood as a fairly respectable one. In comparison to the M113 and YW531A, the 323's hydrojets brought superior speed and maneuverability in water in comparison to the use of track movement only. In terms of firepower, the usage of two 14.5mm KPV machine guns and a fully rotatable armored turret made it far superior to the pintle-mounted 12.7mm machine guns found in comparable vehicles, giving the 323 some decent capability in terms of infantry support and even light anti-armor capacity, sufficient to knock out other APCs or armored cars. The vehicle appears to have been a hit for the KPA pretty much as soon as it was pressed into service. The 323 has been mass-produced since the early 1970s with no sign of stopping, and has clearly become one of the most common armored personnel carriers in the North Korean People's Army. It might very well be the most common and highly produced North Korean armored vehicle outright. Out of the around 2,500 armored personnel carriers the KPA was estimated to have in the late 2010s, it would not be surprising if around 2,000 were of the 323 model, though a variety of other foreign and indigenous types are also found in the North Korean arsenal. In service, the 323 mainly outfits the KPA's mechanized battalions. They consist of about 550 men, with three infantry companies, each with 10 323s, an anti-tank platoon, a mortar company, and an air defense platoon, all of which typically operate vehicles of the 323 family, and a battalion headquarters unit that includes between one and three vehicles of the 323. Overall, somewhere around 50 323 APCs can typically be found in a standard North Korean mechanized battalion. Ever since it had first been observed in 1973, a couple of different missile configurations have been seen for the 323 as well. A configuration which does not appear to be seen in any publicly available photographs, but appears in documents of the Marine Corps intelligence activity, shows the 323 with dual SA-16 EGLA man-portable anti-aircraft defense systems mounted on the top of the turret, towards the rear. It also sports an AT-3 Sager Malyutka mounted on top of the dual 14.5mm machine guns. This version would theoretically vastly improve the capability of the 323 when dealing with armored vehicles and aircraft, but it has never been spotted in operation. Another configuration there are photos of was shown during the 1992 60th anniversary of the Korean People's Army military parade. This configuration has the 323 mount a battery of 8 EGLA missiles on a mount on top of the turret, which would theoretically give the 323 some considerable firepower against helicopters. It ought to be noted, however, that none of these configurations have ever been seen in operational exercises, and as such, whether they are actually operational at all is highly questionable. The North Korean People's Army is sometimes known to mount missiles presumed to be non-functional on vehicles in order to deceive enemy intelligence. It has been mentioned by a reliable source that, fairly recently, small numbers of 323s have been seen with a 30mm automatic grenade launcher, a North Korean-developed weapon. Such a secondary weapon makes perfect sense for an APC with serious infantry support capabilities, such as the 323. The large production of the 323 and its ubiquitous status in the KPA has resulted in the vehicle being featured in a large number of North Korean propaganda films, and being very often shown in footage of exercises or parades shown by the Korean Central Television. Interestingly enough, the use of 323s in North Korean war movies saw the armored personnel carrier being used to depict American vehicles North Korean troops were facing off against. In this use, the 323 was repainted with Allied white stars, as during the Korean War, as well as a text saying, U.S. Army. The use of the 323 to depict American vehicles has been spotted in at least two 1986 North Korean war movies, Myeongnyeong Komichiho and Chogye Nure. The 323's ubiquity and large production led to a large number of variants being made at Shunong Tank Plant using its chassis. The 323's chassis is arguably the most commonly used for a large variety of roles in the KPA. The first derivative is another armored personnel carrier version, which retains the lengthened hull in comparison to the YW, but removes the turret, replacing it by a mere pintle-mounted 14.5mm machine gun. The additional space was used to allow for better infantry carrying capabilities, notably a double rear door. As first produced, this version appears rather rare, but it was used to create a whole variety of vehicles which used the free space created by the lack of turret to mount very different weaponry. Very interestingly, some used the space to mount multiple rocket launcher systems, either Chinese 107mm Type 63s or North Korean 122mm, all while keeping the infantry carrying capacity, making them rocket-armed armored personnel carriers. Those vehicles appear to be known as Songun in KPA service. Another vehicle which uses the hull of the turretless 323 is the Type 85 or M1992, an anti-tank guided missile vehicle which is armed with a rear-mounted battery of Malyutka Susongpo missiles and a pintle-mounted 14.5mm KPV. Yet another turretless 323 variant is the Command Post model, which appears to be the most commonly used command armored vehicle in the KPA. This model features a raised rear compartment, likely to accommodate better communication equipment and maps. It appears to retain a capacity of about 10 men. The 323's hull has also been widely used to create self-propelled guns, some seemingly geared towards anti-tank use while others are artillery pieces. The anti-tank vehicles mount a 100mm gun, likely derived from the Soviet BS-3, in an open-topped rear casemate which replaces the turret and infantry compartment. The presence of dual-opening rear doors suggests this vehicle was based on the turretless variant of the 323 to begin with. These 100mm tank destroyers appear to have been developed pretty early on, seemingly being in service since the first half of the 1970s. The self-propelled artillery pieces based on the 323 mount the 122mm D-30 of Soviet origin. Two models exist, designated as the M1977 and M1985, with the difference mainly being in terms of superstructure. The M1985 appearing to be more mature and long-term, which, for example, removes the towing hook of the field gun that had been retained on the M1977. Both vehicles remain quite similar, with a rear-mounted open-top casemate. Mortar carrier variants also exist. An 81mm mortar carrier is known to exist and has been designated as the M1985, but no publicly available photos of the type appear to exist. Another mortar carrier, the M1992, which has been theorized to actually date all the way back to 1978, mounts a 120mm or 140mm mortar in a rear-mounted, fully rotatable turret, likely inspired by the Soviet 2S9 Nona. The type does not appear to be extremely common in KPA service, though, with no footage of it appearing to be in existence outside of the 1992 parade. The 323 hull has also been used to create light, self-propelled anti-aircraft guns in the form of the Quad ZPU-4, existing in several models, one untitled, and one given the name of M1983, in a hull which features some extensive modifications in comparison to the original 323. Though more modern self-propelled anti-aircraft guns now exist in KPA service in the form of the dual 30mm armed M1989, the lighter 323-based 14.5mm vehicles likely remain in service as well. A cargo and anti-ship missile version of the 323 also appear to be in use. And last but not least, the chassis of the 323 was taken as a basis for North Korean engineers of the Shunong plant to develop an amphibious light tank that also takes inspiration from a variety of other vehicles, the M1981 Shinhyung. This light tank, quite common in the KPA's arsenal since its introduction in the late 1970s, uses the hull of the 323, slightly wider and lengthened by one road wheel. Another, earlier amphibious light tank mounts a rear turret on the hull of the 323 with five road wheels. Despite its reputation of being isolated from the rest of the world, North Korea actually maintains a pretty substantial export branch when it comes to military equipment. Though the most common exports tend to be small arms and missiles, armored vehicles can sometimes be exported as well. In the case of the 323, two customers are known. Zimbabwe appears to have purchased some vehicles around 1984. In 1985, Ethiopia took delivery of a number of 323 APCs, along with the Chanma Hose and the M1977 self-propelled guns. Disappointingly, no footage of either of those 323 operators appeared to exist, though we have a number of photos of 323-based M1977 self-propelled guns in Ethiopian service. In public imagination, when one thinks of North Korean's land equipment, the first vehicles that come to mind outside of perhaps large ballistic missile launchers the Strategic Rocket Force has recently started to operate tend to be the Chonmo-ho and Songun-ho family of tanks in their large variety of variants and armament configurations. The country's vast fleet of self-propelled guns, which includes some very peculiar vehicles like the M1978 or M1989 Coxswains, likely comes second. Few think of the small armored personnel carrier that is the 323. Despite this, it is by all means a workhorse of the Korean People's Army, as well as one of, if not its most durable and common vehicle. The most produced armored personnel carrier of the Hermit Kingdom ever since the 1970s, the 323 is also the vehicle of which the hull was used for the widest variety of armored vehicles. Not even the Takchon or Chonmo-ho chassis can even come close to the 323's in terms of variety of use. With its chassis being used for a wide variety of vehicles, and its parts being shared with even more, several of which are likely still in production today, the 323, despite already being nearly 50 years old and vastly obsolete against more modern armored personnel carriers, is most likely here to stay in the KPA, even though some more modern APC options such as the M2009 Chonma-D or wheeled M2010 have appeared in recent years. This concludes our video series on the 323 Armored Personnel Carrier. If you liked it, please leave a like and a subscription. You can find more information relating to this APC in the full article, which is linked in the description. If you like what we are doing and want to let us continue working on these videos, please consider donating on Patreon or PayPal. All of the funds will be allocated to improving our articles and videos for you. Until next time, keep us in your sights.